Outside the barricades, the wreckage from the recent rioting continued to be demolished. Even in the ruins, children find some consolation. These Protestant schoolboys have gone into the scrap metal business, looting empty Catholic houses.
What have you been doing in there?
Looking for copper, lead, and brass.
Looking for what?
Copper, lead, and brass.
Copper, lead, and brass?
Yes.
Well, how much you get for copper, lead, and brass then?
You get 53 bob for a stone of copper, 12 bob for a stone of lead.
35 bob for the copper, a stone of copper pipe.
You're from the Protestant area, all you boys, are you?
Protestant, yes.
And all these are all Catholic houses here?
Yes.
Nobody left?
No.
Check one.
Show me what you've been getting then.
It's here.
Yeah. Hey, you, hold on.
Well, look, here's copper tape. From, stove or something. Like that.
Yeah.
And there's tape.
How much is these two bags worth? How much money would you get for these then?
£3.
£3?
Yeah.
What are you doing with this money?
Spend it.
Yeah. What are you spending it on?
Streets and
roads. Well, do you think any Catholic boys are getting any of the same things out of Protestant houses?
Aye. Yes, sir. Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Look at them over in Derry.
Over in Derry, it's kind of a house.
Do you feel sorry for these people who have been thrown out of their houses?
No.
No.
What?
No.
Why don't you feel sorry?
They're always only starting trouble. That's all they ever do.
But the weekend also brought some hope as Protestant barricades in the city began to come down. They were originally put up not so much for protection against Catholic invasion, but as a tit for tat, a counter to hundreds of Catholic barricades built after the August fighting. While the barricades were up, the children enjoyed them, and they sadly reinforced all the old divisions, all the old militant songs and feelings. As the Protestant barricades came down, the army this week prepared to act against the barricaded Free Belfast area, the Catholic heartland. Again, the problem was diplomatic, not military. After Catholic leaders had agreed in principle that their barricade should come down, the army showed up in force on Tuesday morning to oversee their dismantling. After much bitter argument, the Defence Committee and the people at the barricades agreed. But the army's waiting game finally paid off. The Catholic barricades of Free Belfast, the last big ones in the city, began to come down yesterday. The kid glove technique had worked. Now, the army has the bigger job of guarding a Belfast without barricades, a city which the army has to watch day and night for outbreaks of trouble.